Hi Virgo, welcome to Angel Love 333. I hope you're all well, you're healthy, and you're safe. A few things here while I'm shuffling. There will be an extended reading link below in the description box. If the reading resonates with you, you can check it out. Secondly, you can now follow me on TikTok and Instagram. All of that info is below as well. And then lastly, there is a donate button below. It's a fundraiser through YouTube. For Ukraine. It's a nonprofit organization called Nova Ukraine for those people right now who need help and emergency aid. Okay, all the money goes to YouTube through the fundraiser. They take care of collecting it and distributing it to the nonprofit. Does not touch my hands. So any donation will help out a lot. Okay, just even a dollar can go a long way collectively. With the thousands of views that I get on my videos, okay? So know that. No donation is too small. I will personally donate 10% of what is collected up to $1,000. We're doing this for a month. We're just over a little bit of a week now. When you see this video, okay, is when I posted it. And so I don't know if there's anything more I can say. Just appreciate to all of your support, Virgo. I'm going to start pulling your cards here. So I want to say also thank you for all your love, your support, your likes, your shares. They do help me grow my channel, and help me connect with you and your energy. Okay, so let's see what we got here. Now this is a reading for love and money. I will go over love first. Know that, you know, one could, you know, outpower the other, right? We'll see what happens if the, if the money energy doesn't resonate with you, it could be, this is just about love for you, okay? So take the messages how they resonate with you, okay? All right, just going to get one shuffle here as I already did pre-shuffle, but let's see here now. We're going to pull some cards. Give me a moment. I'm going to pull the energies here. I want to also say that if you're dealing with a particular person, roles can be reversed, okay? All right. Interesting. Very nice. I'm going to pull one more card for each one, just because I'm feeling that energy there. Needed one more. Okay. All right, Virgo, let me shut this off. All right. Okay, so Virgo, give me just a moment to hone in on the energy. I'm just going to say a little bit, I'm picking up some financial stuff here. Let me just see here. Okay, this is what I'm getting here for you. Virgo, some of you may have a legal situation, okay, or something to deal with, a contract that could be affecting your money and your finances here. It does feel there's a little bit of timing here, okay, with that, I'm going to say. I feel like it's going to work out okay for you. I'm picking up that energy. Now, the only other energy I pick up, like money related or work related, I'm not getting like a lot of pentacles here in your reading. Okay, that's usually indication for money. But I'm not seeing anything negative. It's kind of neutral is the energy that I'm getting, okay? But I do feel like for some of you, there is some sort of legal situation here. Now you have the Emperor, you have the Seven of Swords, you have the Ace of Wands, and you have the Sun card, okay? So very interesting here, all right? And you have the Envy card, okay, on top of all of this. I It's interesting because I'm seeing this as a positive, all right? But we're going to get back to the envy card here, okay? So you have here the Emperor, the Seven of Swords, the Ace of Wands, and the Sun
That Virgo,
card.
I
I had
had
a little bit door interruption there. So what I was saying about this is very interesting. You have the Emperor, you have the Seven of Swords, the Ace of Wands, the Sun card here. Okay. I feel like there could be somebody around you. Somebody very successful. It could be a boss figure, it could be a father figure. I feel that there's something here. They're not telling you, okay, but I feel it's a good thing. I feel there's some, sorry, I'm out of breath. I was running up the stairs. So I feel like there is some sort of opportunity coming your way that's going to make you very happy here with the Sun card. The Sun card, oh my gosh, it's been coming out a lot lately because the Sun time card always gives me timing around the warmer months of the year, which we're getting into depending on where you live. So I feel like there could be something here in the works with your career, could be business related, right? Something here you don't know about, right? That's bringing a new opportunity for you where a lot of growth, a peace, joy, and happiness. Now, going back to the envy card, I feel with this envy card that somebody is going to be very envious. Okay, there could already, I mean, this may have already happened, but I see that upcoming there is somebody around you who may be envious. Maybe you have a successful business and a lot of opportunities are coming towards you. But I feel like there could be somebody who is very envious of you. Okay, so just know that. So that's the energy I have there. Now, the only other thing I see around money, well, I will say, if you've experienced some sort of loss recently in money, okay, because I do see here with the Eight of Pentacles and the Three of Swords here. So some of you, there may have been some sort of heartache. It doesn't have to be like a loss. Now there could be a workplace heartache, okay, but it's telling me here with the Six of Swords, right? Don't worry about that, okay? So usually this heartache has already happened or loss. So if you've experienced some sort of job loss, work loss, there's something else in the works here. You may get a call back from your boss saying, yeah, I got another opportunity for you. So there is something here I feel that you're going to see some movement, some calmer waters, smooth sailing type of energy. And then look here, you have the Nine of Pentacles, your energy, Virgo. So I feel money-wise, you're going to be okay. Like I said, an energy feels very neutral. Okay, nothing really bad, nothing, like winning the lottery or anything like that. You also have the appreciation card. And I feel what they're reminding you to just live in the moment, be appreciative for what you have. If you receive something, great. If you don't have that expectation. Just really be grateful for what you have now in the present moment, okay? That's the best energy you can be in to manifest, right? Kind of letting go of, heartache, letting that shit go, as I say, and I don't cuss a whole lot, okay? So, appreciation there. I do have a candle called Let That Shit Go. I love it. But anyway, now, as I was saying, some sort of contract too. This could be a new job contract. This could be, somebody hiring you as a consultant. Like I said, I do pick up a legal situation as well. We have a legal situation here, okay? It feels like there is, if it's a legal situation, it feels like there's been some time here with the rest rejuvenation. Could be around an injury. So if some of you have, maybe a workman's comp case or something, that could be this envious person around you or that energy, right? Of maybe a boss or even another attorney here. But I feel like they're saying here you have the Wheel, the Moon card, and the Seven of Wands. You may have some doubts or uncertainty, but I feel that with the Justice card here too, if this is a legal situation, it's going to turn out okay. It's going to turn out, I feel, in your favor. I feel you're going to get justice here. Okay, I feel with the Seven of Wands are saying stay strong because you're going to overcome this. Now that's specific to people who may have some sort of legal situation, okay? Could be any legal situation. All right. So I think we're done with money. There actually was more there with money or career than what I originally thought, okay? Yeah. I see success in your future here, right? Something with a contract, money. I mean, maybe you have a trust in the works here. They're telling you to be patient because there is some sort of timing. But the confusion and the struggle is going to come to an end. That's what I'm seeing here. Okay. I know I spent a lot of time on that, Virgo, but I feel like those were important messages for you. So let's get now down to your love situation. Let's see. Look at that. I want to say here too, you got the victory card. All right. So, oh my gosh. And look at that. Woman holding a coin. All right. So I feel like you got some success here, Virgo, in relation to finances. And this can even be in love. So let's go through your love situation. Okay. So you got the Envy card here. Let's see what I feel that is about here. You have the Emperor, the Seven of Swords, the Ace of Wands, and the Sun card. You got somebody here, okay. Now, I'm just gonna say because Virgo, okay, your energy is really good, okay. I feel, you got that victory card, you have the woman holding a coin, excuse me, right here. Okay, you know your worth here, okay. It's a very attractive, abundant energy. Maybe this person is seeing, right, that you're doing well in your life. So far, I don't know here if this is somebody that you know or somebody that is just around you. This person could be a little intimidated by you. I'm just going to say with this envy card, maybe they are a little bit envious. Maybe things come to you easily. All right. This also could be somebody else around you. It doesn't have to pertain to love. Okay. But just know that there may be somebody around you who is very envious of your success. Okay. You have the Emperor, the Seven of Swords, the Ace of Wands, and you have the Sun card. I feel you have somebody planning and strategizing to come towards you here. Somebody I feel who sees a lot of passion and sees a lot of happiness with you and the potential for growth. Okay. This may be somebody who is kind of hiding and lurking, right? This person here is lurking. So I feel like this could be somebody who's lurking in the shadows, all right? Maybe they're a little bit intimidated. Maybe, this is someone here too who looks very successful here with the Emperor energy. Could be dealing with an Aries. You also have air energy, fire, and you have strong Leo. Okay. So I feel like you've got somebody who's very interested in you. I feel they're strategizing here, seeing how they can make things work. Okay. Maybe they've got somebody looking over their shoulder. Let's get into the reading, see what else comes out. I'm just going to take a sip of water, Virgo. I think running up the stairs did me. Okay. So, rest and rejuvenation. Okay. So, either it's been some time, maybe that you've had a relationship, or I'm going to say here that you could be on a break from somebody here. Okay. There could be a negative energy around this person, too, that may have blocked things, but we'll see. You have the Wheel of Fortune, you have the Moon card, you have the Seven of Wands, and you have the Justice. Okay. So I feel, like I said, there's been some time since I feel a relationship here, or maybe you're on a separation or a breakup. You do have the Moon card, could be dealing with a Pisces or a Cancerian. So I feel that maybe you're feeling a little bit of uncertainty or doubt, or you don't know what the future holds. Can be lack of clarity energy here as well. Okay. So they're telling you to take some time to yourself, get your rest, your rejuvenation, right? Maybe do some meditation. Okay. This also, this envy card can also be you in your thoughts here, right? Can be negative thinking, but clear your thoughts here, gain your clarity. Try to be in a place. This is also this energy here of appreciation, right? Feeling, ooh, like some jets just flew over. All right, as I'm telling you to gain some clarity, right? But anyway, you have here the appreciation card, okay? It goes with that rest and rejuvenation, right? Being centered here, living in the now, living in the present, and meditation does that for you, right? Takes you out of the past, takes you out of the future, okay? Keeps you in that present energy, and it helps to remove those fears or blocks that you can experience or negative thinking. Now you have the wheel, you have the Seven of Wands, and you have the Justice card, okay? So I feel with this wheel, right, there's a shift here, okay? There's a shift. I feel it's going to be in your thinking, your perspective here. I feel there is a turn of events that are about to happen that are going to be quite fortunate for you, okay? Like I said, I see some sort of opportunity here coming towards you, someone coming towards you, whether you know this person or you don't. Some of you, I feel it can be. Some of you, it may not. Okay. You have the Seven of Wands and you have the Justice card. Okay. I feel this is around you standing up for yourself. And especially if you're dealing with a particular person here, you may have had to stand your ground with this person. Okay. To get what is fair and just to you, right? Balance, truth, honesty. And lack of uncertainty here, okay, with that moon card. So, if this is not somebody that you know, all right, I feel you're just very guarded at this time, right? You want things to move in a direction where there's truth, there's balance, there's clarity, none of that uncertainty, okay? Now, you have the contract card. Can mean a lot of different things here. Can be a soul contract between you and somebody here, right? A new soulmate here coming in. Could be a soulmate here that you already know, right? Also, another indication here with the Justice card of truth, clarity, finding your balance, right? Being centered here, okay? As I talked about with the Appreciation card, you have the Six of Wands, the Temperance, the Ten of Wands, and the Seven of Cups. Excuse me, sorry about that. So here's that victory card. Remember, we saw the victory card two times here in your reading, right? There's success here. There is, what am I trying to say here? There is a finish line ahead, I'll say. Okay, you're going to get to the place that you want to be. And it feels like here, Six of Wands for me can be a relationship, okay? But it also can be here getting someone's attention, right? Somebody may be putting their attention here on you, seeing you as successful. Remember, I said that with the Envy card, is I feel like this person, for whatever reason, could be a little bit intimidated, or maybe they're seeing how successful you are, right? And it's a little bit. Maybe they're a little bit envious. Okay, that can happen with couples. That can happen with love interests. You have the Temperance card, strong Sagittarius energy. So, again, I feel there could be a break here, timing with you and this person. I feel like, too, this is also about, tempering your emotions, finding your own balance here. In the situation, okay, because I do feel there is some uncertainty, some doubt here. You have the Ten of Wands and you have the Seven of Cups, okay? For some of you, if you don't have anybody in your life, it just can be that, you've been waiting for some time. You've been waiting for a very balanced and honest relationship with somebody, right? And, it feels like with that Seven of Cups, maybe you haven't made a lot of good choices in your life, okay? And that's what you've been struggling with. Or you've had, like, maybe, the people coming in, you've been having a hard time, with your picker, as they say. But I feel here for some of you, this is somebody that you know too, And that confusion is coming to a close here with that Ten of Wands. Okay, it's being released here. I feel like you're finding your own balance, your own clarity here in the situation. So let's see here under the appreciation now. Excuse me, you have the Eight of Pentacles, the Three of Swords, the Six of Swords, and you have the Nine of Pentacles. Okay. After this, I am going to ask how your person is thinking or feeling about you. Okay. Look at this, the King of Wands. I see the King of Wands too as somebody who's a bit of a planner, somebody who really thinks and contemplates things. Okay. It does feel for those of you who knew somebody, you know, if this is somebody you know, there was some sort of conflict, maybe even an argument with this person. And like I said, maybe you had to stand your ground with this person to do what's fair and right for you. Okay. And that may have even been for you to open up your options. Okay. Because this does feel like an energy of somebody here who hasn't completely decided whether they're ready to settle down. Okay. With you or anybody in general is what the energy gets, you know, I get from there. Right. But also somebody who definitely is thinking about the future. This person does come across as somebody who likes to have their way. I will just say that. Okay. Now, you have the Eight of Pentacles, the Three of Swords, the Six of Swords. Yeah, Nine of Pentacles. This is really nice energy for you, Virgo, because the energy that I get here is that either you are or you will be in that place of appreciation, feeling centered, feeling balanced, finding your own clarity within and knowing your worth, really here is what I get. I feel like maybe you've been spending some time, you know, healing, right? Trying to get to a place where you feel more peace, you feel more calm here, and moving on from maybe a situation that was breaking your heart because of lack of clarity, because of doubt, because of uncertainty here. Because of somebody here, you know, I'm just going to say this could be somebody who has a lot of ego, okay? Their energy comes off as a lot of ego. And it can be somebody here, you know, maybe, you know, their actions were more of intimacy and passion and not a whole lot of emotion or commitment, okay? But I feel like you're finding your own balance, your own peace here. Some of you may be working a lot, right? To pass the time. And now what I like to do too is read these last four cards across. Yeah, okay. Yeah, it's revalidating here. You got the Sun card, the Justice, the Seven of Cups, and you have the Nine of Pentacles. And I feel here you're coming to a place of an end of confusion. And you know, whether it's this person here, we're going to see when we ask what they're thinking and feeling about you and in the extended, their intentions, their actions, love notes, and guidance. I feel like you're finding your own balance and your own peace within you, which is just beautiful because that's how it should be, right? This person should complement your life, you know. Not you being happy because of somebody else here, but I feel you're finding your own balance here. Okay, you're working through, you know, those emotions, you know, those mixed emotions here through whatever has happened. I feel this person is coming back around. Okay, it's like I'm hearing like they're lingering. I know that's a weird word, but that's what I heard here. So they may be watching you, right? Kind of holding back, watching you, whatever. Okay. I'm gonna pull new love in your reading, in your extended too, to see what else happens here. But I feel this reading's really about you sometimes, Virgo. You know, especially with this divine timing energy, you know, there's got to be time for you. And I feel like this is your time right now. So if you're not seeing a lot of action or you haven't seen a lot of action because you needed this time for you, right? So let's see what this person here I see for those of you where this is someone that you know. Let's see what this person is thinking or feeling about you. Okay. Let's see if they're worth your time. I don't know. Let's see. Nine of Cups, Page of Wands, Five of Swords. We saw that earlier. Two of Swords. Okay. Yeah, their energy feels like they're holding back a bit, but Let's go through this. You have the Ten of Swords. So I do feel like there was some sort of ending or hurtful event between you and this person. Okay. Now it's an ending. It's also the hope of a new beginning, a renewal here. Let's see what's below that. You do have the Ten of Pentacles and you have the Knight of Pentacles. Okay. So I do feel, I see communication from this person. I felt that before. I do see a message from this person to try and change things here. Ten of Pentacles, that can be an indication that this person, wants to get to that stable place with you. But I will also say this is somebody who moves, kind of slowly here. Okay. It may be things may have ended because of lack of commitment, or, you've just maybe distanced yourself or pulled away, okay, because of lack of stability or commitment here. But you have the Nine of Cups, the Page of Wands, the Five of Swords, and the Two of Swords, okay? I feel, just as I was just saying, this is someone who their energy has been very indecisive. They've held back. There could have even been a third party situation here or somebody who, they were just someone, could be somebody here who was just out for themselves, right? They may base their decisions off of ego. Okay. You got that envy card here. So I do feel that there could have been some game playing here. Okay. May not be for everybody, or there could have been the third person involved. And it doesn't necessarily always mean another lover, but it can be. It's my third party card. But you have the Nine of Cups and you have the Page of Wands. So I do feel this person, is trying to reconnect with you, right? I'm not too sure if it's just on a casual level. It does feel like they want to open up communication with you. We'll see in the extended more about their actions and their intentions. I'm not too sure if this is someone who, is going to move towards commitment. It did show here the Ten of Pentacles and the Knight of Pentacles. Right, it's a slow moving energy, so I feel that's a possibility here, but we'll see as we dig deeper here in your extended Virgo. So, Virgo, if you'd like to see the extended, we're going to dig deeper into this person who I see is coming back around. We'll see how that goes. I hope to see you there. I hope you all have a wonderful rest of the day or evening, and I'm sending you angel love.